Welcome back, everyone, to the second episode of Perch Pro 2016. We're halfway into day one, and the teams have just made their first report. Stockholms Fiske are holding both points at the moment, so now the three other teams will have to work their asses off to catch up.
Now we are downtown Stockholm. We have been changing location from this morning. We was running out of bite, and when we start to search the fish again, we couldn't find them. So they probably moved with the hours passing, and now we go to some more urban spot, as you can see, and we're gonna fish really more vertical into the structure, like this bridge piles and all this kind of quay. A lot of fish, and we hope to catch a few of them. Let's go.
We are in a lake where there are really big perch, and we're kind of putting it all out there to catch one of them. So we haven't had that super duper action yet, but we have a lot of bleak jumping around and a lot of active fish. So one of those big ones might be in there. Stefan has caught a lot of good fish on a Carolina rig, swimming ribster on a Carolina rig, lifting it from the bottom and dropping it down, waiting for the strike. I've tried that, but now nothing has happened, so I'm gonna try a Texas rig bait instead. Swimming ribster also. This color has worked really good for me in this lake before, so I caught a couple of good ones on this one this summer, so let's check it out.
Yes, we are not going for the numbers today, and it's tough. It's tough to get the big one. We really need and we want the specimen to show you guys, and they're swimming here. So this hopefully this afternoon the rain has stopped, and it's quite warm, and the pressure is steady, and we have seen some decent fish. Hunting small fishes here in the surface, so
we know they are here.
They are here.
Yep, we are putting it all out there. We're going in for catching one fish. One fish is enough. We don't need the numbers, and I don't think we're gonna catch the numbers here anyway. Lot of bait fish jumping. We don't need the numbers, and we can't catch the numbers here. No. We just want that big bite.
That's for sure.
So CWC fishing team are still aiming for the big fish point. So are team Vision Fly Dressing.
Well done, buddy.
First fish after the midday report. A baby, but let's see. Just okay.
Good. Keep them on that side.
Yeah. It's far off 1 kilo, which Stockholm got.
Yeah, they really know their waters.
Yeah, I mean, they live here, don't they?
Yeah.
They live in Stockholm, they don't need to drive far. They could actually fish the waters every single day.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that it's cheating, but it's an advantage.
Anyway, definitely. I mean.
Well, Stefan, theoretically, you could be right. Except for the fact that Stockholms Fiske have traveled almost 300 kilometers from the starting line in Stockholm. Just saying.
Den där jäveln slammar ju jiggen totalt då. Jävlar, man måste ha kommit två...
Engelska?
Yeah. This guy must have come in 200 because it felt like a real nice perch when he hit the bait. I'll take a quick measurement and that's no problem with that.
We doesn't get any under 25 centimeters.
No.
Not yet.
Everyone is over 25.
That, nej. Jo.
The bites just keep on continuing. Even though it's blowing like, I don't know, 11, 12 meters per second. Constant wind. But this one seems to have had a little fight with a pike or something. I don't know if it's a seal or... Okay, let's release this guy.
Just for security, thank you very much. How did you... drop shot and see that comes. I think I'm gonna make a drop shot now.
This is a creature. Name is Sisacomp. It's in the range 2016 and is a deadly bait for perch. Especially on a day like today, where the fish are not so active, this bait is unbelievable. Everything is vibrating, look, underwater. We make normally the nose hooking. Many fishermen don't believe that the fish hook up, but there is the salt inside, there is a good taste inside, it smells a little bit fishy, and they grab it completely. Often they take it from the head, and though the hookup is not the biggest problem. It's interesting, this bait. I try to catch another one. I shake a little bit to make it move. Fish! Look what I've explained. Look where the scissor comb is. He take him from the head, not from the tail.
Outside of the town, we could not find any more activity. And with the rain and the cold weather coming, I think that we needed to find vertical structure. And that's the reason we came to bridges and cay inside the town, because we really think that the vertical structure helps the fish to be a little bit more active longer, since that a lot of depth and those walls, they can climb up and down depending on the level of activity they have. So fishing very close and very precisely against the wall, we could get numbers or bigger fish, both big shoal and big fish lives around those walls. So we're gonna try hard and see if there's more to take.
Oh, probably the biggest of the day.
Ah, nice. Want me to net him?
Nah. It seems like I found a fly that works a little bit better.
Fish. Whoa. It just felt extremely good to take. It's not that big though.
That's even bigger.
Yay!
Great, that's a beautiful fish. That's...
Nice stuff.
Beep, 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 beep. Come on, Dan.
Yeah.
Keep him going. Keep him going.
It's hard to have contact with the jig because the wind is, you see how it's pulling the line? So I try to jig down like this to still have some contact with it. Oh, this was just, oh look, oh there was a nicer one behind this, but this is actually a decent fish. And this is like the smaller guys that we catch today. Super nice colors on them. Okay, swim back and get me granddaddy. Grandpa, is it?
Grandma,
okay.
We want grandma.
Come on, perchy.
And again.
Oh, there it is. You just swing him up like this. Oh, no problem there. Number three. And it's still the red ghost grubby shad that keeps on fishing good.
I got grubby shad too.
I always measure up and I put my fingers like that so I see where the hook should be come up. And I try to get the hook as far up in the back as possible so I still have a wide hook gap. You can see I can put my finger there. Don't put it too low because you will lose too much fish then. What's the matter with you today, Linus? Mm-hmm. Yeah. There we go.
I hate the wind. So bad.
No matter what you guys do, see that you get the box full of these guys. Gunki grubby shad. Red ghost.
Nice perch. But we need bigger.
Yeah, we don't need pike.
Yeah, we have tried to locate a big perch in deeper area, but with no result. So we try to fish for hunting perch when the wind is pushing near the weeds. And we'll see what we can manage to catch here. But I think the fish is traveling around the weed beds quite a lot now. So it's hard to find them, but if we're lucky, we can find some decent fish. Okay, we put it back. Good start.
Skulle väga den?
Ja, det är skitsamma. Vad hjälper det?
That's a fatty.
That's a fatty fish. Yeah, so again, just after the 2 o'clock report, we actually reported zero fish for the last hour of just beautiful fish.
Yep. Found on to some decent head shakes. It's coming towards me. Oh, there's. It's hard to say with the 6 weight.
One.
Oh, it's. No, it's not big. He one. Fooled me.
640 grams.
They're getting bigger. Come on, buddy.
Goodbye, buddy.
Oh, it's okay.
I take it. I take it. Yes.
The Imperium is fighting back.
I told you that. Close to the structure. It's a 40.
Another keeper. Now it's close to 3 o'clock p.m. and the fish really start to feed. I had four fish in four casts. Not so bad. But it's also necessary, we have to catch up.
You sure do, Thomas. Looking at the current scores, it still looks pretty dark for all teams except Stockholms Fiske, who hold both the number and big fish point.
We are still fishing the same spot for more than 1.5 hours now, almost 2 hours, I think. And from time to time, we lose the fish, but there's two or three groups of fish that are turning around, and we try to spot them all the time. So we go from one pile to another one, fish fast, get some intuition about where they are, and then immediately when we get a bite, a short bite or something, we send back the drop shot, and drop shotting, fishing slow on the bottom, then we get good fish. There are 35 to 40 centimeters fish, so it's really solid perch. And in between, of course, there's some smaller one. But here's a drop shot technique. When you have been fishing during 2 hours the same spot, is a good, very good technique that you should think about.
Är du en duktig ung gäddfiskare som vill vara med på Kanalgratis YouTube-kanal? Nu har du chansen att visa vad du går för. Kanalgratis.se presenterar Pike Hero. Uttagningen kommer ske på Sportfiskemässan i Älvsjö 18-20 mars i Kanalgratis monter. För mer information, gå in på www.kanalgratis.se/pikehero eller klicka på länken. Vi ses på Sportfiskemässan och du, tävlingen är på svenska men textas på engelska. Äventyret börjar här.
Sol, vind och vatten.
Ja, fish on.
Vind.
Perch.
Oh, that's a strong one too.
Yep. Catch.
Okay, we're gonna
release that baby.
I'll make a click for you too.
Nice. It's time for food. And we got deliverance. My dad and his girlfriend. Hey.
How are you?
Catering.
Catering. Whoop.
Tack.
Tackar, tackar.
Dricka och banan och grejer.
Banan är bra.
Nej, för fan.
Jo, det är det där.
Nej, banan
är bra.
Nej.
Tack. Nu ska vi fånga fisken.
No.
I'll show you how to eat a banana. And catch a perch.
Nej. Fuck.
Had a bite there.
Okay. So eating those fucking bananas.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
How about catching a perch on banana?
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
You're never gonna catch any.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna catch on this.
No.
What can resist a banana shell? Maybe I can start selling this. Ta svensk rekord på banan. Fan vad jobbigt. There we are one. Yeah. Now I have a banana perch. As I said. And I hope this takes out the rumor of banana bringing bad luck. Oh, he ate it all.
Okay.
Well, let's see.
Perch Pro goes bananas.
Perch Pro goes bananas. I think I keep on fishing, but...
Maybe. Not with banana, please.
Yeah, I take a little smaller. No. I do like a worm out of banana. And just attach it like that with the yellow side down.
This is serious.
Yeah, this is serious.
The banana series.
See how many fishermen I've saved now. Now they can eat bananas for all the future. Brr! It's not your day today, Linus. You haven't had your banana yet.
No, my banana.
Okay, let's leave Team Banana and check what Vision Fly Dressing are up to. It looks like they've got some pretty dirty weather coming up.
Got some shit stuff coming in there. What are you doing?
I almost fell off the boat. Yeah, that's some serious weather coming in. Looks like it anyway.
Yeah.
Do you think that's the weather which we drove away from?
Then it's been coming faster than anybody expected.
Yeah.
It ain't looking good.
It's no record breaker.
But it's approved.
Yes, it's approved. Yummy, 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 yummy.
And now, Truman is going to show us how he makes a leader for Carolina rigging.
Yeah, I'm doing a leader here for my Carolina rig. I'm using strike wire, fluorocarbon, 0.28. It's a perfect size, I think, for this kind of fishing. So, and I'm gonna shorten my leader a little bit, so I have a little bit more action on the swimming ribster behind the bullet weight. So we'll see.
On the Carolina rig, you always have that part of the retrieve. When you stop, the bait dies and stops in the water. Then it dives down with the sinker, and when it hits the bottom, it also stops. So you kind of have like two stops in one go with the Carolina rig, and that's really effective when the fish is not really into biting the soft baits, the Texas rigs or the traditional jigs that go up and down like this. So you have like two stops in one go. That's a really nice one when you're jigging the Carolina rig. Also, the Carolina rig can be retrieved to just scoop the the bottom. So there's many ways of presenting the bait. And what Stefan is doing now, shortening the leader, makes the bait, as he said, more twitchy and move a bit more.
Yeah, it's not ready yet, but here you have the bullet weight. And I think I'm gonna have my leader like that. Maybe maximum 30 centimeters. Also, I have a fast touch one here, so I can switch the length of the leader very quickly. It's working quite good, actually. Okay, now we need a hook. My favorite knot is a uni knot. Actually, normally I do 8 turns. And then gently push the knot tight like this before I slide it down. And then you must tighten it. It's a really nice one. Ready to go! Oh, fish! Oh, I lost it.
After hours and hours of persistent fishing along vertical structure, Frédéric has finally hooked into a really nice perch.
This is a big one, huh?
Yeah. Fuck!
No! Broke the line? Why? No. Oh, leg. Look, maybe a pike. Hook. Cut off. It was a pike.
No.
No?
No.
Don't think so?
No. It was not a pike.
It seems like Team ILLEX Gunki just missed their chance of getting the big fish point of the day. You just can't afford losing big fish during a competition.
I helvete! Fan!
Fuck! There's mussel on the bottom.
Yeah.
I think we don't check so much our leaders.
So it's 4 o'clock, time for report. Just small ones. We got some, really difficult, but we got some shitty weather moving in, so we're gonna move to a cove that is safer because here, when driving here back and forth here, we need to pass the open ocean.
We are far out in the archipelago.
And if the wind picks up a lot more, or not maybe so much more, then we're sort of screwed.
Here it seems calm, but
yeah.
Let's see now when we get.
Yeah,
maybe it's us being over cautious, but
yeah.
Better safe than sorry.
Yes, but one fish each, so that makes 2 and a total of 15. The same biggest fish. Okay, let's go.
Today I'm using a ILLEX rod. It's called the Artist S200TM. And it's a superb rod for jig fishing or drop shot. It has a casting weight of 5 to 25 grams. And it's very, very sensitive, so you feel every little bite. And the reel I'm using is an old Shimano Arenium. Of course, I use the slide braid from Pison Michel. It's a 0.08 millimeters. So it's real thin, and I fished this, actually this is the same line as I fished the Perch Pro last year, and I've been fishing a lot. So you can see the quality of the line, the colors and everything. Okay, Linus got a fish on. Is it a better one?
I don't know.
We can take the net in case. Oh, it's a regular size. He inhaled that one.
Yeah.
Perch. A big one.
Come on, baby. Come and see daddy.
Not so big, but nice fish.
Nice fish.
Let him lying down on the bottom, no move. Yeah. The fish are bigger. Honestly, I don't move the bait the second time. 2 big fish. Fall down on the bottom, give them a rest. They come and just swallow it. It's unbelievable. It's deep inside, maybe too deep. I want him to survive.
Now watch closely. Thomas has a tip for helping the fish survive by stopping the bleeding with the help of a Coke.
Outside of the boat?
Yeah, okay.
That can be fine.
That was a new one.
Though this stops the bleeding immediately.
Thanks for that interesting tip. Yet another reason to always bring a few Cokes when fishing. Team Visionfly Dressing are on their way out of the cove, and except a swimming deer, they also find a huge amount of baitfish just outside the channel. With this amount of baitfish, there must be some big lunkers hanging around.
The idea was to move to a different cove, just like safety precautions. We didn't know what the weather was like out here. When we came out here, it's no problem yet. So we'll just stay here and just look at all of those minnows that are being chased up in the surface and the perch are down below them.
Huge amounts of small minnows. And underneath them, the big guys are lurking.
I would just need to get him to take.
Yeah.
I just had a follower, a big, big perch. First time of the day, I can guarantee that fish was above. That was more than 1 kilo, that's for sure. What's that? That's the bottom. Yeah. It just came all the way up to the boat. It just followed the fly. So they are here. I think we're not going anywhere, Danny. We're hammering it until it gets dark. I don't care. We're not going to go anywhere at all. We stay here.
Stefan just had a really nice follower, and now they've decided to stay exactly where they are, trying to get one of those big perch to bite their flies. Where there's bait, there are predators. All of a sudden, Daniel is hooked up.
I'm not sure. No. Go well. Come on. No. Just get it to know that's a nice fish, I think.
Need help?
Yeah, please. It's a good fish.
A big fish. That's a big fish. Ooh.
Yes! Woo! Awesome!
That's a very, very, very good fish.
Woo! Nice stuff.
Okay.
Finally, Visionfly Dressing have a big perch in the net. The question is, will it exceed the weight of Stockholm Fiske's top fish at 1 kilo?
Move that. 1.02.
You tarred it?
Yeah.
Love you, man. Ooh, kilo fish!
Oh, beautiful, man.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Finally. Finally, the kilo fish. Awesome. Hells yes. Fy fan vad gött. Changed. To a similar one that Stefan has. I wouldn't say it's a pretty one.
No, it's probably the most ugly fly.
It's butt ugly, but it has two tungsten cones and a power rattle tied underneath the Mylar cord. And then a tail, of course. Okay, it took like two casts.
Yeah.
Let's see if it takes one more.
Oh yeah, good
Other
fish.
Minnows? Oh, good fish.
I think so, yeah. Same story. Just let it sink, slowly retrieve it. Just imagine that we'd be spending the whole day like 100 meters from here.
Yeah.
But what to do? We only need one fish.
Yes.
Oh, it's good. It's a big fish.
We stopped because we saw all these minnows in the surface.
See the one behind
you? Yeah, I saw it.
That's even bigger.
Big.
Look at that one. That's bigger.
Oh, that's a big one.
This one is good fish, but the other one is bigger.
The other one was really big. Hell,
ooh,
man.
That's a killer fish as well.
I'm going to get my fly in the water.
Yeah.
Can you take care of that?
Yeah. Just hammer them. Keep on going. They are on the feeding frenzy at the moment. So there you go. Out. 60.
cool stuff.
960 grams. Another nice fish, but not bigger.
Okay, I got them behind the boat now.
So now, Danny, now you got our fish above 1 kilo. What do you think?
Yeah, well, that was sort of our goal. Not sure if it will do.
Well, you're not going to settle.
No.
We're going to keep on because they're going to come back, and that other fish following that fish.
Fuck me.
That's right. You can never settle down and feel safe in Perch Pro. All teams are very skilled, and every cast can mean a new top fish for any of the teams. ILLEX Gunki are still searching the fish close to vertical structures and missed a really big perch a few hours ago. But now Frédéric is hooked up with a big fish again.
Yes!
Yes!
47.
Hey! Yes, baby!
$122. You've done it!
Yes!
Ladies and gentlemen, Perch Pro 2016 has a new top fish, caught by Frédéric Jullian on an ILLEX knocking jaw blade bait. Well done!
Woo-hoo-hoo.
Fred, we are in the business again!
The 122 we took could be enough, but you know, it's a lot of very fine angler in the other teams, and they know the waters. We are outsiders. We are not Swedish, and we don't know the waters. So I'm scared that they get very good fish in reserve, and that 122 will not last long enough. So we keep searching for bigger fish, and we hope to catch it. But if we don't, we will switch again to numbers, trying to catch up with the team which is in front of us, Stockholm Fiske.
Just need that really big perch. And
then we're home.
Who knows? Maybe the last hunting light will get them to feed, because I think they're standing on the bottom, because all the perches that we got have worms on them, so they're slow, really slow.
We have been going around the lake to try to find some new spots. But we came back to the spot where all the bait fish was at, the dace and the bleak. And they were jumping, and we saw a big pike, and first cast or second cast, I caught this little critter on the piglet shad. With a 10-gram jig head, really high up in the water, so they're chasing, they're hunting down the bait, so probably there will be some bigger fish here. I brought it, I'm at it. It's a good one.
Not so big, but
shit, he lost a big one.
I lost a really nice fish. It was...
You need a net? Just tell me.
Stop. No, this is not the big one.
Ooh! Oh shit!
They are here. Now.
Small one. Ooh!
Oh, that's a nice one.
That's a better one. There we go. Could this be the biggest one yet? I don't know. Not.
I think so.
We need them to be bigger than this, but.
Nice fish. Put it back.
Nice one.
Take one.
Whoops. Whoa, 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 whoa. Jag tycker vi ska gå.
I think it's perch.
I think we should...
No, but we stay here because they're going back and forth here.
Stuff everywhere.
Yeah, but it doesn't feel so good, but it was stronger in the beginning. I think it's about six, seven. Let's see.
My line also. Oh, that's a good one. Yeah, that's the best one so far.
Yeah, it's ooh, nice today.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a nice fish. If we're lucky.
Yes,
now,
if we're lucky, yeah.
Yes. You know, we saw a good perch jumping and feeding here, and I just threw it there, and a couple of twitch.
Boof. Ooh. Shit.
Very nice. Very nice. A couple of twitch, just waiting, and tick. Yeah!
Nice one.
Nice fish. But it's... What do you think, Abbe? 700? 800?
I think it's more because it's very wide.
Maybe. Yeah, we
hope so.
Try to measure it. See what it weighs. Nice! Perch fishing is fun!
New top fish for CWC Fishing Team. 1 kilo. Nice fish, but not big enough. And now it's soon time for an evening report.
Okay, that was the last cast. 32 fish.
We have done our best today, and we try again tomorrow.
We have a 122, which is a correct one, and could be a winning point. Maybe.
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 Let's hope so.
The first day of Perch Pro 2016 is over, and now it's time for the APM report. Now the teams will find out who have caught the most and biggest fish for the day.
This is Stefan Jensen from Team Vision Fly Dressing. The total amount of fish is 20 fish. Biggest fish is 1.02 kilos.
Okay. Hi, this is Tom from Stockholms Fiske. We got a number of 173 perches and a top fish of 1 kilo.
This is CVC Fishing Team. Total amount of fish, 25. Biggest fish, 1 kilo.
Team number 4, we have 32 fish, and the biggest fish is 1.22 kilograms.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Thank
Sleep
you.
Tight.
Bye-bye.
Oh, crap. That was too bad.
Well, yeah, beaten on the finish line.
Yeah.
So, Stockholm Fiske had, I'm not sure about the number. But at least they are way ahead anyway, so
yeah.
I think it was 153, I'm not sure. 1 kilo, CVC 25 fish, 1 kilo, and Gunki was 32 fish, biggest fish 1.22. So it's 1 point.
1 point.
And Gunki 1 point.
Yeah.
Oh man, I fought.
Okay, as I said,
yeah, we got the numbers,
yeah, and the ILLEX got
1.22, and Vision has 1.02,
yeah,
and CVC has 1 kilo fish,
yeah, but it doesn't matter, we got 1 point,
yeah,
for sure,
yeah, they can't beat us in numbers.
No. So 1.2 ILLEX and 1.2 us,
yeah.
But it's you know, Stockholms Fiske, as I expect when we talk about it,
yeah.
I was expecting 150 or something, and
yeah.
Now it was 130, but still...
So it was 130 fish, yeah.
I think
yeah.
It was like that, and they have...
1 kilo fish.
Still that 1 kilo fish
yeah.
Since morning.
I think they went for numbers, and that 1 kilo fish was only a bonus.
Could be.
That's my theory.
But this is fun. First day, bad weather, but we're fighting to the end. And of course, we didn't catch a monster.
Yeah, but we still have a hope side.
So
yeah.
I think we should be satisfied in this condition,
yeah.
In this lake.
Yeah. Of course, we have...
Next day is another day. Beware of
it's
that.
New day tomorrow. And the big fish are out there, we know that.
They are.
And it's all day it seemed like we could have caught it any time.
Yeah.
And clearly we didn't go for the But we didn't have the shoal to go for the amount.
Yeah. For 170 fish, you need big shoals. Mm. If it's a small shoal, you empty it a little bit and it slows down immediately. That's the problem. Yeah. If you have 1,000 perch around, you can catch 170.
This we get them 2 days ago, but we couldn't farm them.
Yeah.
And also, we need to rig with smaller bait and downsize on drop shot.
We have to check what we have in our
boxes. In big shoal, what we can get out.
So we decided that we're going to go back to Stockholm now.
Yeah.
The wind is picking up and it looks shitty.
Yeah, when you look at the forecast, it won't almost be possible to drive a boat here tomorrow.
We're going to go back and we're going to take shelter in Stockholm.
Yeah. Hope the forecast is still good.
Yeah, it's going to be better than here.
Yeah, definitely.
I think it's going to be impossible to fly a fish out here tomorrow.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, let's get going and get the boat up.
Yeah. Day one is over and we have the final scores. Stockholm's Fiske caught the clearly largest number of perch with 173 fish caught, giving them the number point. All the teams caught fish bigger than 1 kilo, which is really remarkable. And the biggest one were caught by ILLEX Gunki, giving them the big fish point. So after day one, Stockholm's Fiske have 1 point, and ILLEX Gunki have 1 point. Ladies and gentlemen, don't miss the next episode of Perch Pro 2016. Make sure to subscribe to Canal Gratis to get access to the best high quality fishing videos on YouTube. Thanks for watching. See the final episode of Perch Pro before everyone else, together with the competing Perch Pro team in a house-shaking Hard Rock Cafe on Friday, February the 5th. Get an exclusive ticket for $4.99, including starter, main course, and drinks. Only a limited amount of tickets are available. Follow the links to get your ticket right now.